I think that, Karen, it was interesting in January when we made our first announcements about all the steps and actions we were taking. You know, I was met with tremendous criticism that you're scaring people, you're alarmist, this isn't going to be a thing, there's no reason to worry. In February, more than a month ago, when we were one of the first agencies, the first entities in the entire state of California to declare a public health emergency and a local health emergency, we got the same thing. But the reality is we saw this as a thing to be of concern. And we felt like everything that we do would have the opportunity to flatten the curve, which is why we put in place a dedicated plan focused on the homeless, dedicated engagement with our hospital systems to get the equipment they needed, standing up our emergency operations center, being very transparent with what we're doing in testing, daily interaction with CDC, with the military, with everything. And then the situation in San Diego has been further complicated, and we're one of the jurisdictions in the country that has received the most outside patients. We started with all the folks that were repatriated from China right here in the Miramar. And to date, we've taken almost 500 individuals from the Princess Cruise Line. And so every day since January, we've been working and focused to try and tackle this issue. And I'm very proud of the work that the county has done. You know, unlike maybe in the past, you have the county and the cities working together, speaking with one voice. Our state leaders have been very helpful and supportive. And so there's nothing in a global pandemic that any jurisdiction can do to avoid any of their folks getting it or avoid the spread. And there's always lessons that can be learned. But I think the people of San Diego should be pleased with all of their elected leaderships in this crisis coming together and working hard to try and protect them.